Hi, did you know you can now run Python codes directly in Excel? Yes, Microsoft has recently introduced support for Python formulas within Excel. Maybe you have heard about it, but here is the thing. Many users are excited about this, but they find it difficult when it comes to getting started, from figuring out the syntax to knowing what works inside a cell. I am Kailash Sharma, and in this video, I will walk you through a simple practical example to help you start with Python directly in Excel. So let's get started. So we are going to learn Python in 5 steps. So first, we'll understand what is data frames. Okay. Then followed by using describe option, which is available in Python. Then few data formatting changes, like getting the column names from some data and then summarizing the data by certain columns, and finally creating a sample chart. Okay, so here is the sample data. As you see, it has got name, age, city and salary. We have got around 50 records. Now this data is into Excel, and very first thing that you need to do is to convert this data or load this data into Python. And loading the data to Python is like loading it to data frame. So when it gets loaded, what you get is a data frame. So in Excel, if you know, it is range, but in Python, when the data gets loaded, it is called data frame. So how to load the data to Python? So let's start with the function. For that, we will write equals to py. Now py stands for Python. Whenever you want to create a formula which includes Python, you have to start with py and then press tab. So you get into the Python code. Now as you see, there is a py has come, and basically now it will interact, or the formula will understood as a Python code. So first, what we will do, we will say df is equals to the range. So this is my range of data. I'm going to select till the end like this. So what it says, so this is Excel data and this is my range, and it is able to detect that there was a header available at top. So header is true, and entire this range is getting stored in something called df. This is a variable that we have named it as df. Df is like data frame, right? Now if you press enter, it is not going to do anything. Basically it will create one more line. Okay, so if you want to execute any Python code, you have to use control enter, and that is how the any Python code can be executed. So you can see initially it was showing busy, and then finally it got executed, and what you got is data frame. And if you want to go like click on it, it will actually show you the preview of this data. While it will not show you entire data, but it is telling that this data frame has got 50 rows, 5 columns, and the data looks like something like this. Okay, now the data is loaded. Now what we need to do with the data? So first of all, what we'll try is we'll use something called describe. Describe is like giving a summary of the data. So here I will write it, and please be sure that do not write any code which is dependent on some data frame before where you have declared. For example, here this code is written in cell I3. If I try to write something here or above the rows, the code will give an error. So you have to use any dependent Python code in the same row after this given column or in the next upcoming rows, like that. Okay, so let's start with py tap. And where is our data? The data is here, but we loaded already in variable called df. So we'll say df and then dot describe, and right, since it is a function, we'll open the bracket and close the bracket, press control enter so that the function can be executed. And you see what it has written. Again, it has written the data frame, data frame is again like a tabular format, but you don't know what it is. So first is you click on it and you can see the preview of it. Let's say that it is not giving you full data, right? So what you can do is you can also show this directly into Excel. And how you can do it is select that code or the formula, and then from here in the formula bar, instead of Python object, click Excel value. So it will actually give you the entire data like that. So what it is telling, so it is summarizing the data. So what it is saying, it has got 50 number of rows in ID, age, and salary. The mean is this, standard deviation, minimum, maximum, those kind of details are mentioned, right? And it is able to detect that which are the number column and which are text, and it is giving you the summary of numeric columns. If we don't want this, if you want to change it back, we can click on Python object. Now, the data frame is there, and if you want to know the name of the column, so what you can do, just for understanding purpose, again, we'll say equals to py, and our data frame was df.columns. Press Control Enter, saying busy, and now it is giving index. Index is basically, it has got a few rows of the data, and if you want to see this data again, you can click here and say Excel value, right? You are getting, what you are getting is the column headings, right? This is how you can get it. Now, let's see. We want to summarize this data by city and salary. So here we have a few cities available and the salary, right? Now, we want to summarize it in a way that the city name will come and the total salary will come. Maybe total, I will say. So what formula we will use in Python? We will use this formula, which is equals to py dir and then df dot group by. Now, what we are doing is here, this data frame, we are doing a group by city, followed by salary. And for salary, we are using sum as we wanted total, right? And we are using the reindex function. Okay. If we press Control Enter, showing busy, again, we got data frame. We wanted to know what it contains. Let's see. Click here and you see city names are here and it is telling you the total salary. Right? Okay, now let's see one more code which will help you to create a chart on top of the data frame. Okay, so we'll say py, enter, and we'll paste the code. The code already I have written in past, so I have just making use of it. Control enter, and let's first try to understand what this code is doing. So first it is importing a library so that we can create a chart out of it. And then we are using another variable to store this data based on the grouping by the city and salary. Salary, we are using mean because we wanted to show the average salary. Okay, so we are summarizing this data and then we are creating a figure, which is a chart where your x-axis is city and y-axis is salary. And then we are plotting a bar chart into it where your x-axis is mentioned and y-axis is mentioned. And then finally, the labels and the title. Now, you might be seeing where is that chart actually. So what you can do is you click here and then it is telling from here what all it is coming as a return. And we wanted the chart, which is a kind of an image. Click on this image. If you see, very small image has come here, right? Not readable enough. So what you can do is you can right click on that cell, picture in cell, picture over cells. So it will come out really well, right? So here the full image has come. It's a chart which is created using the Python codes. Hope you like this video. Subscribe us for more videos like this. Thank you.